Janjambure, which is one of the Gambia's most prominent upcountry tourism and historical hotspots, is recently augmented with signages and other directional aids. While unveiling one of several signages, including this one at the Kankurang Center, the chief of Janjambure, Bakari Jangjao, said that the site and anything which goes to bolster tourism in provincial Gambia is very important. Sheikh Omar Jalo of the National Center for Arts and Culture delved on the vitality of the intervention.
Thank you once again for another milestone in
YEP, NCAC and Community of Janjambure Partnership,
and the support of the Youth Empowerment Project. Today we are unveiling the signages. This would explain the heritages around the island of Janjambure.
A tourism consultant at the Youth Empowerment Project, Ngone Pane, went on with the importance of the signages and the information panels, indicating their capabilities of fostering self-guided tours.
We are like a family. We are working together towards the same goal, to bring development to the youths of Janjambure and the surrounding communities. The information panels is just a way to demonstrate the wealth of information, the wealth of history, and the wealth of culture within Janjambure. These information panels were made to demonstrate the history, to document it, so visitors coming to Janjambure will be able to read, will be able to see while they go through the Kankurang Center or all other historical and cultural sites.
The acting director, National Center for Arts and Culture, Hausum Sise, also touched base on their partnership with YEP, which is duly aimed at fostering youth employment in line with the National Development Plan.
In the National Development Plan, tourism and culture are a priority area. And what we have, you know, been doing with YEP is to support youth employment, youth empowerment, and community development through culture and tourism. So this is why, you know, the panels we are unveiling, throughout, the island of Makati, is basically meant to support the interpretation of the cultural and historic sites, so that tourists will come, so that the guides whom we have trained, about 20 of them, will be engaged.
Being the National Center for Arts and Culture's regional cultural officer in the area, Demba Balde equally portrayed the move as instrumental in the development of upcountry tourism.
The Methodist Church and School was established in 1835, and therefore the earliest such establishment in the protectorate, and continues to be the oldest functioning Methodist church in Black Africa. So this is very great and is very important in the history of the island. There comes Amitage and the colonial cemetery. These are all brought here by the British, who acquired this land in 1823.
Reporting for GRTS News, this is Moru Bajan in Janjambure Central Region.